Now, if I were to tell you to name 5 things that you can associate with the color red, I'm sure one of those things will have to be Zomato. So in today's video, we look at the business model of Zomato, try to understand how does the app make money and understand the growth strategies of Zomato. If you're interested, keep on watching. And welcome back to the Marketing Empress. So in the case of Zomato, I think it's one of those brands that has stood the test of time. Initially, we always use the brand to read about food reviews, to read about restaurant reviews, etc. And then later, with the introduction of Swiggy, the option of food delivery was also added. Zomato Gold, or today Zomato Pro, makes us all feel special. So I believe the brand has ensured to change over a period of time to get the perfect customer satisfaction in place. Through this video, we will cover the following topics. Number 1. History of Zomato. Number 2. Analyzing the revenue streams for Zomato. Number 3. Important factors of the business model. Let's begin with the first one. History of Zomato. Not many of us might be aware, but Zomato started as Foodie Bay back in 2008. The founders, Dipinder Goyal and Pankaj Chadha, are IIT graduates. The basic thought behind the app was that consumers find it really difficult to store the physical copies or leaflets of restaurant menus. And there should be a digital form of it available somewhere to store this kind of information. So from then till now, today, Zomato is one of the largest food aggregators in the world. What they've managed to do over a period of time is to ensure that when it comes to food or visiting a restaurant, our ways of selecting a particular restaurant has completely changed. More often than not, we will browse Zomato reviews. We would want to see how the restaurant is rated and then possibly consider a visit. So from even a restaurant's point of view, it becomes very important to get ranked well on Zomato or get a good rating on Zomato. App also gives you access to book a table, thereby ensuring that your waiting time at some restaurants has reduced. Clearly, talking about it today in 2021 may not be as relatable, but trust me, before COVID, this is how you actually visited a restaurant. But think about it from a broader perspective. Even today, when you're not visiting restaurants, Zomato is still a part of your life. Because they did introduce food delivery, they introduced other ways in which you can consume food from your favorite restaurants through the app.
Revenue streams of Zomato. Now, Zomato has managed to generate millions and has expanded on a large scale. So there clearly has to be a steady flow of revenue. Let's understand some of these revenue streams. Number 1. Advertising.
Now, for most of the businesses these days, the major chunk of their revenue comes in through advertising. And same is the case with Zomato. Now, until very recently, Zomato was only used as a directory where you could find information about various restaurants in various areas. So it was just about listing those places on the app. And then possibly having reviews or something like that. But now, with the introduction of food delivery, there is a better opportunity for brands to advertise on Zomato. So you must have come across a banner on top of a restaurant listing or something like that. So say for example, I want to look for a restaurant closer to a suburb in Mumbai. When I look for that particular search option, there might be a few restaurants which rank higher. How does that happen? That is actually the restaurant advertising on Zomato so that they are the top two or the first and the third option or something that comes up when they are advertising for that particular spot on the listing. Okay. As a matter of fact, 50 to 70% of Zomato's revenue comes in through just these ads.
Number 2. Food delivery.
Now, Zomato charges a fixed commission when it comes to food delivery. So, the amount that you're actually paying when you order from Zomato takes into account the commission taken by Zomato and the money that the restaurant will incur as well.
Number 3. Restaurant listing.
Now, restaurants pay a fixed monthly subscription for being available on the listings. Now, this fee will be a regular fee if you do not want to rank your website restaurant higher. But you can also pay a little more and make it rank higher if you do not have good ratings. So, if you do have good ratings, as the app works, it possibly will still rank your restaurant higher. You need not pay separately for your advertising. But if you do not have good ratings as of yet and you've just recently come onto the platform, advertising is a good way to get noticed.
Number 4. Zomato Gold or Zomato Pro.
Now, Zomato Gold, which is now Zomato Pro, again worked on a subscription model whereby customers could subscribe to the features, and it worked brilliantly in the case of Zomato as well as restaurants. There was a time I clearly remember when I had Zomato Gold access, and I would actually filter out restaurants based on that. Because earlier they had this whole thing of getting one-on-one on drinks as well as one-on-one on food menu listings as well. So it was a win-win situation for all. This was one of the revenue streams for Zomato, and today it's turned into Zomato Pro, which is very similar to Zomato Gold but is more so inclined towards food delivery.
Number 5. Consultancy.
Now, this is one of the lesser known streams or revenue streams for Zomato. Now, what happens is that, say for example, you are a restaurant owner and you need to open a burger joint somewhere in South Delhi. Now, you know for a fact that you want to open a burger joint, but wouldn't you be interested in knowing the likes or the dislikes of consumers residing in that particular area? But how do you come across that information? Through Zomato. Now, Zomato has this amazing tracking tool which helps you understand the preferences of consumers in and around that area based on the number of orders placed and the kind of reviews or feedback received. So, as a restaurant owner, I'm very much interested in getting this information in. Am I going to get it free of cost? Definitely not. I will have to pay an amount for it, and that acts as a revenue stream for Zomato.
Now let's look at the important factors of the business model.
Now that we know the revenue streams for Zomato, let's look at the other important factors that have led to the success of the brand.
Value proposition.
One of the most important things that worked in the favor of Zomato is its value proposition. It's a one-stop solution for both restaurants as well as consumers. So whenever it's about food, it's most likely supposed to be around Zomato, because you get so many things which are very much unique to Zomato. If I were interested in food delivery, I would possibly consider between a Swiggy and a Zomato, and then the whole concept of discounts come in. Where am I getting a higher discount? Where am I getting a chance to pay lesser? I will opt for that. But it's the only app, Zomato, wherein you can have a look at the reviews, you can have a look at the ratings, etc. If I need to visit a restaurant, this is the only app that gives me all the information that I need.
Customer relationships.
This app acts as a great way to build customer relationships. Now, it may not always be the case and you may not even realize it, but depending on the ratings that a particular restaurant receives, it overall determines the customer relationship that they can build. And there have been so many restaurants that I've come across where the reviews talk about the hospitality shown by the hotel or the restaurant. And it acts as a major boost when it comes to visiting this restaurant for others, because hospitality, believe it or not, plays a major role in you deciding whether you want to dine in at an X place or a Y place.
Customer segments.
Zomato manages to reach in varied customer segments. We have varied cuisines, we have varied locations, everything. But Zomato ensures to have all the information provided to you under one roof. To conclude, Zomato is one of the best examples of a brand that has taken strategic moves or strategic advantages to ensure that the brand sticks around in the long run and is evolving and developing for their consumers and better services being provided to their consumers. Do let us know in the comments below if you want us to review the business model of any other brand which has intrigued you, or any other startup that you need to know a little more about. So that's it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed and learned something out of it. If you did, please leave your valuable feedback in the comments below. Anything negative or positive is always appreciated. Like this video, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell notification icon so that you are notified each time some content gets uploaded on The Marketing Empress. We upload content every Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday. So ensure that you have the bell notification icon switched on so that you do not miss out on any of the updates. Until next time, bye-bye.